The final amateur cook is counting on his hometown flavors to snag him an apron.
Yes!
My name's Christian Collins. I'm from Gloucester, Massachusetts, and I'm a stay-at-home dad.
You are invited to cook your signature dish for the judges, MasterChef in L.A.
Hello.
I got something in the mail.
I have a 9-year-old son at home, 11-month-old little girl. Her name's Adalia. And one on the way. I've had some ups and downs in my life. I worked in restaurants growing up for a little while, typical dishwasher. I kind of veered off of that, just being a teenager, just figuring out life, doing drugs, kind of hit rock bottom, wasn't around for my son. Gets to a point where you do wake up one day and realize that that wasn't the man that you wanted to be. My son was about 3 and a half when I turned my life around and came back, got custody of him, and then realized this was my passion and came back to it.
Chewy, but awesome.
It's lobster. I had to fight through a lot of things in my life, and I'm going to fight through this competition and win it, because it's going to change my life around.
Give me some love! Come on! How you guys doing today?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Very good.
Where are you from, buddy?
I'm from Gloucester, Massachusetts. Oldest fishing port in the country.
What are you cooking?
It's basically a cioppino. I like to call it a shipwreck sea stew for my son.
What's the secret behind this stew?
Start with a little onion and pepper, some white wine.
Garlic.
Tomatoes. Clam juice.
The love of food came from where?
Cooking for my son.
You feed this to the kids?
Yes.
Let's go.
So let's hope the shipwreck stew is not your culinary Titanic.
You're very nervous.
I've never wanted anything more in my life.
That is like you. It's intense and it's packed full of flavor. Good job.
Thank you.
Really good job.
Thank you very much.
Delicious.
Thank you.
It's very tough to pull that off.
Thank you very much.
Wow.
The dish is more confident than you are. You should sing like that dish sings.
Sure.
For me, definite yes. That's the kind of dish that wins competitions like this one.
Mm-hmm.
Graham?
Yeah, I think that the dish speaks for itself.
For me, I'm a yes.
Put this on, go out and intimidate him.
Woo!
All right,
good job.
Don't let us down, bro.
I will not.
Well done.
Thank you very much.
Yes!
You still want to dive in that pot, don't you?
This is amazing. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely spot on. He could win MasterChef.
He really could.
This is my dream, and it's happening.
Oh, man!
Whirl?
Yeah, I did.
Okay.
I liked it.
Tracy is a good cook. I don't think she has as much food knowledge as I do. I think it looks ridiculous.
Sorry, I liked it.
And that's where you kind of hit a wall sometimes with some of these people. I'm not telling you because I have this idea. I'm telling you this because I know this for a fact. Probably gonna do a little roasted corn, a little bit of onion. I'm gonna put that underneath the scallop. I'm gonna make a little sweet pea puree. I certainly hope I win today. I haven't won a box challenge in a little while, but I win everything else, so it's fine. I'll drink to that.
Christian has some.
Time's up. I'm looking at my dish and I'm thinking, it looks pretty to me. I would order this off of a menu. I made scallop succotash with a lime honey vinaigrette and a little crispy pancetta.
So seared on both sides. Perfectly. I feel that the crunch really balances against the richness and sweetness that's inherent in the scallop. But I think a little bit of salt, a little bit of acid would have really made that dish come together a little more.
What's in the puree?
A dash of sugar, a little bit of lime, and I thinned it out with a little bit of olive oil.
Great sear on the scallop. You know, really good color with the puree. And, you know, an overall nice dish.
It's got finesse, but it's got heart and soul. Are you back in this competition?
I'm a force to be reckoned with. I'm going to take this all the way to the end.
Good job.
Thank you, chef.
The next.
Good for that.
Christian's always talking a big game, so if Christian's a badass, then he should be able to cook these pork cheeks.
I braised them in a pressure cooker with a mirepoix, a couple apples, some bourbon, a little chili pepper, and then I made an apple fennel slaw with an apple gastrique.
Yeah, I mean, Adrian has just done you a huge favor because you've nailed it.
Thank you.
And it is absolutely delicious.
That's a super top-notch dish. You should be proud.
Thank you, chef.
Good job.
Adrian, your plan to eliminate Christian backfired. You nailed it, buddy. Good
Thank
job.
You.
Congratulations. Thank you,
Adrian made a grave mistake. So take that, Adrian.
That's good job. Really good job.
I'm the captain.
Christian, put your ego back in your head.
You're gonna win this with green apples.
Yeah.
What do you think about the red team?
I think they're gonna overcomplicate their.
Well, I gotta say, I think that a lot of your competition around here are looking at you as the guy to beat, so.
I think they're thinking the right way.
Wow.
No lack of confidence.
No lack
here,
of confidence.
Huh?
Well, stay at home.
There's not enough heat, and Jennifer's obviously not smart enough to figure out to use the fryolator burner, and she f***ed up the caramel.
And it was really bizarre because every time a member of your team was coming forward with an idea, bang, you squashed them. Is that just arrogance or selfishness?
I was the team captain, so I took charge of my team.
I think I'm a better cook than him, so it's cooking absolutely.
Christian?
I'll go head to head right now. I know I'm a better cook than her.
I'm very confident in my skills. I cook by touch and feel and instinct. It takes a little bit of balls.
I'm gonna make a great souffle my way.
You know, sometimes you win, sometimes you lose.
Today, someone's gonna go home on the back of your lack of leadership.
We're here to play the game.
Where do you wanna go home?
I want Jennifer to go.
One on the left is superb.
This is it, yes?
That is my souffle.
Okay, great. What's in there?
Cheddar, a pinch of Parmesan, a little bit of chive, some mustard powder, some garlic powder, and I rimmed the ramekin with Parmesan.
Okay, visually, it's got that impact. Smells good from here. What's the texture we're looking for in the center?
It should be nice and fluffy and still have that little bit of creamy edge from the cheese.
Here, and I'm just dumbfounded. Christian is the powerhouse. That's not what I expected.
Christian. You haven't made many souffles.
No.
The soup could have used a little more seasoning. The flavors are good, but it's a little dry for my liking. Okay.
I think at this point, the judges have been a little bit harder on me than other competitors because they, you know that I'm going to be a great chef someday.
Christian is the powerhouse. Either of you team captains would have to be nuts not to pick Christian first. What is she doing picking me first?
Tracy.
This person has been with me on numerous team challenges. We work extremely well together, again, balancing off some of my weaknesses. That's Jennifer.
Wow. Wow, wow, wow. First of all, I've never known you to be last pick. Normally you're first out of the box. What's happening?
I don't know. Ask them. I wasn't picking.
It's simple. I want zero conflict. I want to be the leader of the team.
I don't know. I think Tracy made a big mistake. This is what I do. It's comical to me that they left me for last. I'm looking over at Tracy and I'm thinking, fool. It's going down.
Christian.
pressure's on in this one. If you want to be a chef, this is what you're going to be doing. I need to show the judges that I have what it takes to do this as a profession. Thank you.
So the red team takes it.
To win is awesome. It's going to be tough to see one of them three leave, but hey, everybody has to leave at some point. Top five, I'm feeling awesome.
Five steps away from winning it. I'm going to take everybody down.
Right, Christian, competition getting down to you plus four. Did you think you were going to get this far?
Yeah, I did.
Really?
I'm going to make it to the end, Chef. I'm going to win this.
Who do you think is going to do the best version of this dish?
I am.
Why?
I'm good at recreating. I'm good at looking at a dish and putting it back together. Hopefully do you right and be able to recreate your dish just as well.
Who's leaving?
Susie.
Susie's a very smart intellect.
Yeah, she overthinks.
Who's happy with their dish?
Wow.
I'm feeling great.
My dish looks spot on, and I think I did a fantastic job.
One.
Let's do it.
I got everything on the plate. It tastes really good. I wouldn't do anything different.
I tried to, as hard as I could to make it taste the same way. I think I really captured the aesthetic of Gordon Ramsay's plate.
If you could put the kind of bravado and attitude that spews from your mouth into your plate, I think you might be a top contender.
I haven't been called up into the bottom once. I think they expect great things out of me because I'm great.
I want to win MasterChef more than I've wanted anything in my whole life.
The title means more to me than the $250,000. I came here to prove this to me. I want the MasterChef title. I'm taking the MasterChef title.
Get some.
Having grown up the way I grew up and having to like fight for custody of my son and fight to not do drugs, I feel like I've been fighting my whole life.
And now I'm fighting for the title of MasterChef.
Susie knows that I'm a strong competitor and I'm one of the best here, but I am the best here.
But I want to say Susie picked me because she knows that whatever team I'm on, I'm going to win.
I anticipate taking Jennifer and Adrian down, but at the same time, I feel like they're better chefs than Susie. Susie overthinks things and she doesn't move quick enough for my liking.
Christian!
I'm Kunal Kapoor and I happen
to whammy. Mikhail Ansky, a famed food writer from Israel.
First woman to ever open a farmer's market in Israel.
It's like a food walking Bible, right. This lady. I mean, extraordinary. Kunal Kapoor, famed across India.
He's currently nominated for Chef of the Year in India.
To be the judge at the MasterChef India.
My name is Sébastien Demorand. I'm a judge on MasterChef France.
Shalom, Red Team. My name is Michal Ansky, and I happen to be a judge on MasterChef Israel.
Red Team, our fellow judges have traveled thousands.
Embarrassing.
I told you Thanksgiving was a bad idea, Susie.
It's not that, though, Christian. It's our execution that sucked.
Susie's still trying to defend Thanksgiving dinner to me, and I'm not having it. At that point, I'm pissed at her. I'm pissed at myself. It was humiliating. Should have never listened to you, Susie.
Christian's getting super defensive.
As the losers of the team challenge, Christian and Susie must now face a pressure test, after which one of them will be going home.
Susie keeps saying she wants to go head-to-head with me, and she's getting her wish. I'm pumped up. I'm going to take Susie out in the pressure test, and then we'll be rid of her.
Never have I ever made a lemon meringue pie before. I'm a little nervous. I don't want to go home, but that's not going to happen.
Susie's going home today.
Why do you carry so much baggage on your shoulders? Why is that? Is that you in general?
I've had a pretty tough life, so, you know, sometimes it comes up. I'm going to show you today that I came to win.
Stop!
Good luck, Susie. You're going to lose it. And then there were three. Hey, it sucks to go home, but everybody's gonna have to go home except me at some point. Only one person can win MasterChef.
Yes!
I want this so bad. Top three, it's like right there. I'm gonna take it. You are looking at the next MasterChef.
N. Christian, the single father from Massachusetts, who was a strong contender from the very beginning.
Jennifer thinks that I lack creativity. I really don't care what Jennifer thinks, because when I take her out of the competition, then she's gonna have to eat those words. The judges aren't really liking my plating, and yeah, I don't really care. If she didn't want to give me flour, just say you don't want to give me flour. I can handle that, but don't try and blow smoke up my ass like you need all your flour. I don't really care if she doesn't want to share a flower or whatever. I'll do it without it.
I'm excited. What's going on here?
Braise the ossobuco, a little root veg medley with some yellow romesco, some simple mashed potatoes, salt and pepper, cream and butter.
But you wouldn't put a bone-in pork chop over a bed of mash, right? You want me to finish the plate for you?
If that's what you feel like you need to do.
I'll slice it for the benefit of my other judges so they can have a nice bite when they get up here to eat.
Joe pulls my T-bone off there and slices it up and puts it back on my plate. I'm thinking, you, Joe.
We love that determination, that spirit. You've produced some magic. Follow that dream.
You have the determination and focus to take you a long way.
Thank you.
Come here, you.
Come here, brother.
You arrogant.
You arrogant.
You've got the right to tell me that when you've won 3 Michelin stars. Get out there and get those stars.
I'm going for speed and experience in the kitchen. Christian.
As a captain, I think Max fell a little bit short. He's never ran a kitchen crew before, and that f***ed us up.
From you, it was really something subpar. We were very disappointed.
I think you're wrong. I don't think my dish is the worst dish here.
Esther's dish looked pretty
Think what you want.
Let's go. I couldn't have asked to be a team captain for a better team challenge. I can't wait to just start the game and take Ben down. Just fine. Girls, I like them. They're a little bit more dramatic than guys. And I think when it comes to being in a kitchen, you can't really have a lot of drama.